MPs and they support Brexit. The real worry I've got is David Davis, who of all the people in the cabinet I would have thought was closest to my kind of Brexit position, even David Davis saying this morning at Hunters 2 that perhaps leaving the single market and leaving the customs union will need to be reconsidered. And what Tory central office have concluded is they've concluded that campaigning for hard Brexit has cost them votes. Now, I think that analysis is wrong. I think in the end, this is more about personality. She failed the test. She didn't look like a leader. And Jeremy Corbyn was having a ball. He was going around the country, engaging people, getting new people out there to vote. So it seems to me that even David Davis is considering putting the single market back on the table, that the whole Brexit process has really very seriously been damaged by this election.
As we speak, about half a mile down the road, we're told Mrs. May is attempting to put together a government to cope with the new circumstances. There are some reports she's already been in touch with the DUP to get their support in Northern Ireland. Can she pull it off?
Well, maybe she can put together a government, but can she pull off the Brexit process? Four times in this campaign, I saw her asked, as somebody who back Remain, do you now believe in Brexit? And four times, she could not answer the question, just that I'm going to do the will of the people. You cannot go to Brussels and negotiate something as important as this unless you believe in it in your heart. Now, I'm told she's going to stay. She won't resign today. But I do think if Brexit's to be a success, we must have somebody who believes in it leading the government.
So you think the Prime Minister should go?
Absolutely, yes, I do. I think she's failed completely. I think she has weakened her own position, not just within British politics, but she's weakened the UK's position with these renegotiations.
And yet if